Hey everybody, it's Stacy. It is June 8th, 2009. I did not go to my meeting tonight. I went to the library and I had to work on an essay that I was doing about I'm doing it about dilated cardiomyopathy, which is what Ed passed away from. So I wanted to work on that. We got finals coming up next week, and we have this essay due Friday. So I went to work on that. Had a little moment. Something happened today, just something simple to everybody, but to me it just bothered me. Just felt kind of like something happened that made me feel a little out of control, a little trapped, and it kind of stressed me out. And then, just a lot of emotions are just running raw right now. We lost our last two chickens this weekend, and me and the girls took that real hard. It was the last of Ed's chickens that he had raised since he was a since they were baby chicks, and it was just hard to, like, close that chapter on the chickens. And I know that sounds stupid, like, just chickens, but you know, I can remember the day we got the chickens, and there's just, it was hard to close up the coop, you know, one final time. So it's been just a day, and you know what, tomorrow would have been my monthly grief group, and again, I'm losing it about that time each month. I have looked into another group that starts this fall, which I'm looking forward to going to, but what this brings me back to is that basically I fell off the wagon tonight, and I was searching for Melissa's phone number, which I found and called. You know, it's almost like having Melissa is like having your, like almost a sponsor for an addict. So I just got off the phone with her, and she made me feel better. But basically what happened is I have all this anxiety and the stress right now. Doing this report about the dilated cardiomyopathy was hard to learn all the details about it, to be honest. I don't know. Just how, you know, the percentages of the disease and, you know, the treatments. And it's hard to study about something like that when you've had something personal happen to somebody you love. But afterwards, I stopped and to get a pop, and I ended up picking up a bag of chips. And I went home, and I had, you know, the bag of chips was a small bag, and it was like 280 calories, which I can have. And then I had a meatless chicken patty and these chips, which is fine. But then for some reason, like, after that, like, I, like, lost my mind. I was full. I was satisfied. It was good. But I needed to, like, eat. I needed to, I didn't want to feel anything anymore. But I went and I had another chicken patty and finished the bag of chips. And I had like a whole container of blueberries. I ended up like unwrapping like four pieces of cheese and like ate that. Basically within like a 3 hour period, I ate like 1200 calories. Which is close to what I eat for like a whole day sometimes. And it's not even the like, for today I think I ate like total of 2,500 calories, which is the most I've ever ate since I've been on the program. I felt completely out of control. Like when I was eating that stuff, I felt like I couldn't stop myself. And that was scary. And that's when I knew I had to call Melissa, and because I didn't want it to, like we always say, one binge is, you know, scary enough, but it's the second and third that get bad. But I talked to Melissa and I feel better. And my girls overheard me on the phone with Melissa, like, confessing all this stuff. And they were both so supportive. They come in, Tony come in and talked about, you know, Mom, you have to fall once in a while if you want to make this successful for the rest of your life. And I'm like, that's pretty much what Melissa had said. And I know they're right, but it's so scary because I don't fall that often. And I guess that makes it when I do fall, it scares me even more. But, like I said, I'm feeling better, just feeling a little down, just a lot of stuff coming in today, because I had a great week. I had my birthday, I had a surprise birthday party that was awesome. Just a great week, and then for something little just throws me off the edge. But I just wanted to check in with everybody that, you know, from the group and let you know that I'm alright and I fell off, but I'm already back on and I will be in there next Monday. If not, please come get me. But I love you all and I will talk to you next week.